Hey YouTube, Chris here, Open Roader Channel. And you know what? I don't hate your bike. I just really love mine. So first I want to say real quick, thank you to the Italian people and the Italian government for handling this pandemic and getting this all under control so I can have the freedom going for a ride without having to stress about it. So we're still social distancing and all that good stuff. We're still wearing masks, but we're allowed out, and that's what I'm doing. So I want to say that I love my motorcycle, and there's a lot of reasons that I do. I really like the Scout. For a person of my size, I'm 5'10", 185 pounds. It's great for me. It doesn't feel like a small bike. I like it because it's light and nimble. Makes it really easy to maneuver. Works well for my wife and I. You know, she's 4'11", so she's pretty small. And I've got it dialed in. I like my bike because I've got it dialed in for me. Doesn't mean I got a problem with somebody else's bike. Okay, I don't hate Harley Davidson. I'm not a total Indian super fan boy where I'll never ride anything but an Indian ever. You know, I like this bike. I like some of the other bikes in the Indian lineup, and if I had the money, I would probably own them all. I like sport bikes as well, but I wouldn't ride one just because I think I'm too f***ing old for that now. I like anything on wheels, to be completely honest with you. I like Vespas. I wouldn't mind taking one of those home when I return back to the United States. I don't know if anybody's coming, but I'm going. I like cars. I've always liked, you know, cars, motorcycles, any of that stuff. So I'm not prejudiced towards one or the other. I really like this bike because I've been able to set it up, and you can do this with any bike, I know that you can. For me, I have been able to set this bike up exactly the way I need it, okay? And when I say that, the way I need it, it's because where I'm at and the roads that I'm riding on, I couldn't ride, you know, a piece of rolling sculpture. It just wouldn't work. These roads are way too rough. I couldn't have a small bicycle tire up front. I already struggle. Some of these roads, they dig a trench, but they don't compact the dirt down. So when they re-asphalt it, you get grooves in the road. And even with my big front tire, I still struggle to keep it in the lane and out of those grooves. So, you know, and the same thing would go with a giant fat tire on the back. I mean, those bikes, beautiful as they may be, would never work for me here in Italy. So the Scout has just been such a perfect machine because of the way I've been able to set it up. I know it's not everybody's cup of tea. Don't really give a fuck. This is for me, my machine. And like I said, I don't have a problem with other bikes. I don't have a problem with, you know, Harley Davidsons. I think they're still beautiful. I'd still wouldn't mind going back and getting a vintage from. I had an opportunity, real quick story. I had an opportunity to buy I think it was a 2007, somewhere right around there, vintage. Beautiful bike, man. A friend of mine had it. He had three bikes at the time. And he was making payments on that bike, and he offered it to me as a just takeover payments, no money down. And he was already, you know, two-thirds of the way through it. And it had black saddlebags on it, it had a windshield on it, it had, you know, nice exhaust on it. It was ready to go. And I could have had that for a song, but it was at the wrong time. It was right at the financial collapse. 2007, and I couldn't. I was in my own, up to my own neck in trouble. So I've thought about that bike a lot, and now, you know, that bike now, this many years later, they're out there with super low miles, and that is something I could see myself purchasing. You know, that bike is probably $5,000-$7,000 now, or less, who knows. And I could see myself riding that. So, and then I could strip the Scout back to nothing. You know, so the Scout, when it doesn't have anything on it, is awesome. Absolutely awesome. Now, I did want to talk about some of the things that I've heard and read about the Scout that I personally feel are completely false. Complaints that, oh, well, one of the problems with the Scout is that the power doesn't come on until way late in the power band and the RPM range. It's true. It doesn't really, really take off until, you know, 5,000 RPM, and then it's going. But the reality is, there's so much torque in this motor that you can ride around no problem with damn, man, look at that place. You can ride around no problem, and you're not short on power because there's so much torque, and all these V-twins are that way, you know. But the Scout has something different going for it, and it's similar to what the Challenger's got going for it. Look at this thing, man. And that is that these things have a high RPM red line. So unlike a pushrod V-twin, these things really rev out. And that's one thing I just love about the Scout, and I bet you I would love about the Challenger, is because you got some RPM, and I like to rev things out. I like having the torque down low so I can just pull out like this. Don't need to worry about it. And then I like being able to wind it up. Now the power's coming on. Whoa! Fuck! Dude, this thing is not a joke, man. The Scout is not a f***ing joke. Any of the reviews that I've read about people complaining that there's not enough low-end power or low RPM power, and that you can't enjoy the bike until you get it into high RPM, that's just f***ing bullshit, man. These people who, you know, they ride some other bike, and then they go do a test ride, and then they're on the bike for 20 minutes, and then they give the definitive across the whole internet decision. Bullshit, man. I just, that does nothing for me. I've been riding this bike since 2016, and I can tell you this thing does a lot of things amazingly. And I highly recommend, if you're even considering purchasing a cruiser, go ride this Indian Scout. Take it for a ride. And the Bobber's even got more power than the standard Scout. I mean, these things, and dude, an exhaust, a tune, an air cleaner is very reasonable. You know, talking under $2,000 for all that shit, and you've got a pocket rocket, man. You've got something that's not going to stand up to the top end sport bikes, but damn near everything else on the road you're going to be toe-to-toe with. And that's a nice feeling. I've not had any issues keeping up with anybody, be it on the freeway or just tearing around town. I mean, I've definitely dusted plenty of things just tearing around town. But the Scout for me is just the perfect bike because it can be outfitted and stripped down. You know, if you go buy a big cruiser, which are pretty damn cool, but if you go get, you know, a Road King, you're not stripping that thing down. If you go get a Roadmaster, you're not stripping that thing down, okay? It's never going to be a little bar hopper. And that's one thing that I love about the Scout, is it can be an international super tour, because I've done that. I've driven this bike through, I don't even know how many countries, man. 10, 12, 15 different countries, and it's an international tour. That is no question. I got enough luggage space. I got enough, you know, everything. Maybe could use a little more gas mileage, but that's okay. I'm fine with it. The people I ride with typically aren't, but you know. But I like the fact that I can then strip it down to nothing and enjoy it as just a naked bike, basically. And this thing's got plenty of juice and handling. I mean, I typically drag either the tip of the tailpipe or the kickstand on corners. It's part of it. I think that unless you're getting into a Ducati cruiser, that you're going to struggle to get that kind of cornering. But it comes with cruiser territory. You know that going in. And if you don't, I'm here to tell you, cruisers drag things when you corner. Go get a sport bike if that's what you're looking for. But the Scout just does it for me. You know, this, now I'm 4 years in. I can't believe I've had this bike for 4 years. How many miles we got on this thing? We got, 33,000 kilometers. Do that math. So, you know, there's definitely people who've got a lot more. I knock on wood, I haven't had any issues. I've had, you know, a few things I got to deal with. You know, you got to do your maintenance and tighten things, and that's part of it. I have to do it myself because I don't really have there's a dealership, one that's really close now, but it's so expensive, man. I just can't go over there. I'm not going over there. Spent $500 for nothing. You know, over here they want 220 euro, which is about $245, for an oil change kit. And in the States it's, you know, $74 or something like that. So that tariff is a killer. Same thing goes for parts. And I'm not just not paying for the part and the service. I can probably do it myself. And now I've got my local mechanic, David, who I still go to. I gotta go stop by and see how he's doing. I haven't seen him since this whole pandemic thing. But yeah, my Scout, my bike, not saying it's better than yours. It's just what I like. It's for me. This is my bike. You go ride your bike. And with that said, thank you everybody for tuning in. Always appreciate it. And catch you the next time. Peace.